My name is Aquil Charlton. I'm a teaching artist, electronic musician, and songwriter. I do visual art, mostly from like a graffiti background. I like tinkering, so I also make music instruments out of recycled stuff. I started with building this mobile music box. That was like my main, like a really big project, mobile teaching practice where I can teach music activities from a bike trailer cabinet that has live production equipment, that has a dock where I can plug instruments in and materials. If I wanted to do music instrument making activities, it would have recycled materials that I could use to teach how to make music instruments out of some interesting stuff. One of the things that I want to do with my mobile music box is to use innovative ways of broadcasting, of amplifying the sound that I make during these street studios. So when I bike around to a neighborhood, if I sit up and make beats, I have the capacity to, you know, broadcast very shortly to like radios nearby. This whole tinkering with music instruments is part of wanting to grow as a sound artist. So not just electronic musician, but thinking about sound on a physical level. And so I spent a lot of time thinking about how to use recycled materials to do like acoustic treatments, really thinking about like the ideal sound that I want in my studio and how to get there using materials that I fashioned in order to make warm sort of density that I wanted in a room or not in certain areas of the room. And I've replicated that in the small gallery at the Logan Center. I spent a good chunk of my residency working on that and trying to coordinate programming that relates to all these different things. I've also been researching and studying the work of a songwriter named Eugene McDaniels, who is I think a really prolific songwriter and producer. He's one of those unsung figures in popular music. And what I found most fascinating is that he's, you know, a black sort of radical songwriter to the point that he's one of the contemporary banned artists, the artist whose work has been banned by the United States government. And I think that that's something to study and look at as an artist with a social consciousness to the work that I write and just like, you know, as a human being. Here at the Arts Incubator, I have what I call an altar or an ofrenda to G. McDaniels. It's really a cultural education piece. It's a teaching piece. If I were a tower of strength. It's been great to have a space to work. I'm a new father and my space at home is compromised by a 2-foot-tall, beautiful child. And I have to figure out how to work, you know, with sound and noise and those sorts of things. And so this has been a great space to just work. I can make as much noise as I want. So that's been great. Having access to a wood shop has been way more fantastic and useful for a musician than one would think. I've had some tools to work with that I normally would have to either rent or borrow or whatever. It's really been nice having other artists to work with who aren't musicians. I think that like being able to step into the studio next door and talk to Nazi and sort of like see her process and, you know, how her work has come together has been great. The staff has always been really nice and supportive. I mean, I would say that it's just allowed me to really flesh out the work that I thought that I wanted to do. So like being able to put it into practice, I think, is what it's really allowed me to do. My music is a call to action, right? It's try to like at least give something to somebody who would do the work to listen. I want somebody to dig into my stuff like that and be moved to think about their world differently because of what they hear. That's what I hope that people get out of my art. Too close to the legend folks by the